Hello students, this is Shweta Roy. This video is for Chapter 7, Part 3, Our Forest. In this video, we will have a quick recap of the chapter which we have done till now. Also, we will discuss the question answer of the chapter in this video. Our next topic is forests and their importance. Why forests are important to us? Forests help us in various ways. They provide us fresh air. We receive products such as resin, rubber, wood, bamboo, and essential oils from the forests. They are home to a wide variety of flora and fauna. They prevent soil erosion. They are home to people of various tribes such as the Bhils, Gonds and Banjaras. So here you can see the trees provide us fresh air and oxygen to breathe. They provide us resin, which is used to make gum. We also get rubber from the tree. Here you can see the extracting of rubber from the tree. We also get wood from the tree. Bamboos are also received from the forests, and essential oils. Next we have types of forests. So here we have five types of forests. First, evergreen forest. Second, deciduous forest. Third, thorn forest. Fourth, coniferous forest. And fifth, tidal forest. So first we will discuss about evergreen forests, and these are also known as tropical forests. Now this evergreen forest or tropical forest are found in the hot and humid regions of India, like the slopes of the Western Ghat, the hills of the northeastern states, and in the Andaman and Nicobar Islands. So these are the hot and humid regions of India where we can find tropical forest or evergreen forest. Now the main trees which grow in the evergreen forest are rosewood, mahogany, and ebony. These are the main trees which we can find in these forests. Second, we have deciduous forest. The trees of these forests shed their leaves in summer, and they are found in the foothills of the Himalayas and in the southern plateaus. Now the important trees which we can find in these forests are sal, sandalwood, teak, and shisham. These are some of the important trees which we can find in deciduous forests. There is also an important fact which you should know. In a rainforest, a raindrop can take up to 10 minutes to travel from the uppermost. Next we have thorn forests, and these forests are found in areas with scanty rainfall like Rajasthan, parts of Punjab, Gujarat, and Madhya Pradesh. Scanty rainfall means less rainfall, little rainfall. So, areas like Rajasthan, parts of Punjab, Gujarat, and Madhya Pradesh, which are having little rainfall, can have the thorn forests. Now, the trees in thorn forests have long and deep roots. They have less leaves and more thorns and spikes. Now, commonly found trees in these forests are cactus, kikar, and prickly pear. You can see the picture of prickly pear here. Next we have coniferous forests, and these forests are found in the higher slopes of Himalayas and in the Nilgiri Hills in the south. Now trees in these forests have cones and needle-shaped leaves which do not allow snow to accumulate. Some of the commonly Next we have tidal forests, and they are found in the deltas of the Ganga, Mahanadi and Godavari. Now the common trees of these forests are Sundari and Nipa. These forests are also called mangrove forests. Here we have a quick question. Where is the Sundarbans located? How do you think this delta got its name? So, Sundarban National Park is located at the southeastern tip of the 24 Parganas district in the state of West Bengal. You can see in the map. And it got its name from one of the mangrove plants known as Sundari, Heritiera minor. Now the Sundarbans are a part of the world's largest delta formed by the rivers Ganges, Brahmaputra and Meghna. So Sundari is a common tree found in this forest, in these areas, and that is why the name Sundarban is given to this place. Discuss about some of the hard words and their pronunciation. Forest, various, resin, rubber, bamboo. Essential, variety, flora, fauna, erosion, tribes, hills, bones, Banjaras, tropical, humid, regions, Ghat, Andaman, Nicobar, islands, Mahogany, Ebony, Deciduous, Shed, Sal, Teak, Shisham, Scanty, Horn, Spikes, Kicker, Prickly, Accumulate, Deodar, Birch, Spruce, Mangrove, Deforestation. Cultivation. If Reforestation. Reforestation. Habitat. Sanctuary. Endangered. Extinct. Declining. Categorized. Poaching. Unfortunately. So these are some of the important words. You need to pronounce this and practice these words. Now we will discuss the question answer of the chapter. So here we have exercise A, answer these questions. Our first question is, what are tidal forests? The answer is, tidal forests are the forests found in the deltas of the Ganga, Mahanadi and Godavari. The common trees of these forests are Sundari and Nipa. Tidal forests are also called mangrove forest. Second question is, what is the meaning of afforestation? Answer is, afforestation refers to the planting of trees on the land which has not been under forest cover for a long time. It is an effective way of increasing the forest area. Next question is, mention any two steps taken by the government to conserve wildlife. And the answer is, two steps taken by the government to conserve wildlife are, the government has set up many wildlife sanctuaries, reserve forests and national parks to protect our wildlife. Second, putting a ban on killing of endangered animals. Next question is, what are endangered animals? Give two examples. The answer is, the animals which are in danger of becoming extinct are called endangered animals. For example, bisons, antelopes, tigers, etc. Now we have fill in the blanks. Some of the trees which grow in the evergreen forest are rosewood and mahogany. Second, the animal species that no longer exist on the earth are called extinct animals. Third, the Sikkim snake is an extinct species. Evergreen forests are also known as tropical forests. I hope You all understood all the topics taught in this video. Thank you.